Hey y'all, welcome to another Wet Your Whistle Wednesday on Uncle Bub's Bell Buckle Beer Reviews. Hey, this week I've got another beer from my buddy Wayne Allen up there in Pennsylvania. Man, I tell you what, this guy, I just love this guy, man. He sent me some beer, you know, just because he started watching my videos. He sent me some beer, and you know, he's sent me, you know, several now, and I've enjoyed all of them. But I had put out there on one of my videos that I had a hard time finding this one beer, and I really wanted to try it. And my buddy Wayne found it for me up there in Pennsylvania, and he shipped one down here to me, which is not an easy task because this beer comes in a bottle. All right. So today's brew is one I've been wanting to try. I've seen it on the internet. I can't find it around here. I have a hard time finding anything from Founders. But occasionally I find some. When I do, you know, I pick them up. But this one I could not find. It's one of their barrel age series. This is a Founders Frootwood cherry ale aged in maple syrup bourbon barrels. Frootwood. I've been wanting to try this a long time, man. This just looks like a good beer. It's 8% alcohol by volume. It was bottled in November of 2021, but at 8%, it says it's a 2022 release. I'm just tickled to death to have this thing, man. Wayne, thank you, my friend. I appreciate it. You know, it shouldn't be so hard for us beer lovers to find beer that we want to drink. We should be able to order it online and get it shipped no matter where it is in the United States. We should be able to do that, and we can't. For whatever reason, I can't order this. I can't, you know, I find some online beer stores I can order, and they will ship to Tennessee, and then others will not. And that's just very, very frustrating. Anyway, my buddy Wade took care of me. Founders Frootwood. So I'm looking forward to trying this on a Wayne Allen Wet Your Whistle Wednesday. I love Founders Brews. They are just one of the premier brewers in the United States as far as I'm concerned. Their offerings are just awesome. They have delicious brews. For the most part, they are above, you know, 5% ABV. Their alcohol content is a little higher, and you know, some people like a high alcohol content. Some people do. Others, it don't matter. And you know, a lot of times it don't make a difference. If I'm doing yard work or something like that, you know, a Bush, a Bud, a Miller, you know, whatever is fine. But when I'm trying different beers, I really enjoy trying the variety of beers. I like the higher alcohol content, just for the heck of it. So anyway, let's see what this has got here. Pour it with a little stiffness there. See if we can get some head on this. Oh, look at that. Y'all, I've got an airport. Just a little, it says it's municipal, but it's a little airport. It's about 5 to 10 miles away from me, depending on how the crow's flying. But you may hear some airplanes going over me here. That is a pretty brew. It's hazy. Wow. Look at that. Hazy brew. It's a beautiful amber color. Nice head. Oh man, that aroma. Oh my goodness. Oh, that aroma is just exotic, man. Dadgum. All right, so it says this stuff is cherry ale aged in maple syrup bourbon barrels. Okay, so what I get out of the aroma, just a slight hint of bourbon, but the majority of the aroma, I don't know, man. It smells more not like bourbon, but more of a oaky, an oak type aroma to it. Just a hint of the bourbon aroma, but more of an oaky aroma. I don't smell any cherry at all. But man, that is a pretty brew. Dadgum. Alright, I got a little bit left in the bottle. I'm gonna swish it good before I pour the rest of it in there. But isn't that beautiful? Nice and hazy, beautiful amber color. Nice little head. Two finger head now. Let it kind of die down. We'll get a taste of that head before it goes away. Oh man. Wow. All right, so I can't detect any cherry aroma coming off of it, but man, you can detect the cherry in that flavor of that head, man. That is freaking delicious. Dadgummit. All right, let's give it a swish while we'll put the rest of it off in there. Man, that is good. Dadgum. You can taste the cherries in that head. Come on. Anything in there, come on out. All right. Frootwood. Barrel Age Series from Founders. Now, Founders is, they're located in, where are they located out of? Grand Rapids, Michigan. Man, I've enjoyed everything that I've had from these guys. Now, I had one, it's called Solid Gold. And it wasn't bad. It was just kind of a typical Pilsner type brew. There's a little spider on me. Get off me, dude. Dadgum. Little spider. I felt something crawling on me. Anyway, the Solid Gold by Founders was just kind of a typical brew. But for the most part, and it was in a can. Everything else I've had by Founders has been in a bottle. And just enjoyed them immensely. But this Frootwood, man, is one I really wanted to try. My buddy Wayne come through for me. All right, so delicious. Very, very aromatic. Smelled oaky and a little bit of bourbon. The flavor of the head, I could taste just a hint, just a tiny hint of bourbon. But the majority of the flavor in the head come from the cherries, man. I could taste the cherries in the head. Oh, so it's a beautiful brew, man. Look how hazy that is. Hazy, amber, beautiful. I can't wait to try it. So this Frootwood is for all American workers. Hey, old Uncle Bub here in Bellboca, Tennessee. Just want y'all to know that I love and appreciate y'all. Thank you for the work that you do day in and day out to provide for yourselves and your families and pay your own way and support our economy. It takes us all. Everybody's essential. Everybody's important. If you have a job, you know, you're essential to somebody. So I just want you to know that I appreciate what you do. I work hard. I do 12-hour days. I know what it's like, man. And it takes a lot to make a living and pay your own way. Thank you for what you do. Cheers, brothers and sisters. Oh my goodness. That's delectable, y'all. Man, that's almost like a dessert beer. You can taste just a hint of the bourbon in the body. But I'm also getting just a hint of the maple syrup. Just a hint. Bourbon, maple syrup. And then on top of that, you got the bourbon, the maple syrup, and on top of that, you got that cherry flavor with just a pinch of tartness. Man alive, this is a delicious brew. I've been wanting to try this brew so long. And when Wayne sent me this shipment, I was like, man, I'm going to wait for a beautiful day. And, you know... I wish I'd have done it first now. He sent me six, And this is the fourth one I've done. I've got two more to review by him. But this is just an absolutely fantastic brew. If you get a chance to try some Frootwood by the Founders Brewing Company, man, I don't care what it costs. Now, Founders, typically, I pay a lot more for Founders. Typically. The Solid Gold was reasonably priced, but most of them, you know, especially if you get into the KBS, the Breakfast Stouts, those are a little more expensive. You might give 12, 13 bucks for a four pack. It's worth it, man. The KBS are going to be like 18 to 20, 22 for a four pack, but still, I mean, they are worth it. The alcohol content is high. The flavor of the brew is not disappointing. If you get a chance to try some Founders, absolutely give them a try, man. Don't let the opportunity pass you by, especially if you get to try this Frootwood, man. I'm tickled to death with this stuff. It's delicious. Oh. And, you know, it doesn't have any bitterness at all. It's got just that hint of tartness from the cherries. You can taste the cherry. Yeah, I can taste the bourbon. I can taste the maple syrup. I can taste the cherries and the tartness of the cherries. Man, it's delicious brew. I mean, absolutely fantastic. Tickled death. Thank you, Wayne. Another winner, man. Thank you so much for sending this to me. I've been wanting to try this for a long time. I appreciate you, buddy. All right, y'all. So that's been a Wayne Allen Wet Your Whistle Wednesday this week. I'll be back tomorrow for a Thirsty Thursday. I don't have a typical brew, and I don't have a Tennessee brew. I'm just going to do another brew that I have in my fridge that I saw. I've seen it. Some of my brothers on Alcohol Legs have posted where they've reviewed it, and I've been wanting to try it, and I found it at a convenience store. Unfortunately, it was in a great old big can, so that's all I got to try. It's a great old big can of this stuff. I'm going to try it tomorrow. All right, so y'all stay tuned. Take care. Love and appreciate y'all. If y'all like the videos, there's a little beer mug right there. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. I'm here every Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and occasionally on Tuesday doing a beer challenge. So y'all stay tuned. Take care. Love and appreciate y'all. Cheers. Oh, man, that's good. That is good.